Everyone, and then we'll start. Okay, Jai Jinendra, everyone, welcome to the October monthly meeting of JSCNC. To allow all of us to enjoy this session, please follow these ground rules. Please mute your lines if you're not speaking. If you have any questions during the meeting, please type them in the chat window. Also, please note that we are recording this session to share with people who might not be able to attend it. Now I'm going to turn it over to our JSCNC president, Mr. Ritesh Shalot, to start the meeting. Over to you, Ritesh.
Yeah, thank you, Ketan. So, Jai Jinendra, everyone, and welcome to October meeting. Hope everyone is doing good and again safe at home. First of all, happy Navratri to all of you. May the blessing of Ma Durga be always with you. Before we start, just like you know every other meeting, I would like to jot down the agenda first. So first we'll begin with Navkar Mantra and Stavans. So today we have Jagdish Bhai and Nalini Ben. They are going to lead that for us. Then we'll have two more kids from Mahavir Group who are going to talk about their ingredients project. And then we'll begin our today's discourse on mental health and meditation. After that, I will have some exciting announcements to make. So I'll take that after that session. And finally, we'll have Uvasagram Sutra. So let's start this meeting and let me hand over to Jagdish Bhai and Nalini Ben. Over to you, Jagdish Bhai. Jagdish Bhai, don't mute my show. If you can unmute.
Okay, Jai Jinendra, everybody. Om Namo Arihantanam, Om Namo Siddhanam, Om Namo Ariyanam, Om Namo Vajjayanam, Namo Lue Savasahunam, Eso Panchanamukaro, Savpava Panasano, Mangalanancha Savvesim, Padamam Havai Mangalam.
Om Namo Arihantanam.
Chattari Mangalam. Arihanta Mangalam. Siddha Mangalam. Sahu Mangalam. Kevali Panato Dhammo Mangalam. Chattari Loguttama. Arihanta Loguttama. Siddha Loguttama, Sahu Loguttama, Kevali Panato Dhammo Loguttama, Chattari Saranam Pavajami, Arihante Saranam Pavajami, Siddhe Saranam Pavajami, Sahu Saranam Pavajami, Kevali Panato Dhammo Saranam Pavachami. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Nalini.
Prabhu Tame Arihanta Cho Mare Ari Cheha Prabhu Tame To Jiti Gayane मारे कर में हार मारे कर में हार आत्मना कल्याण ने काजे तमे दीदु बधु त्यागी मारे लोभनो तो मरे ना हूँ तो छू हजुरागी प्रभु तमे अणगार थयाने मारे मोटो संसार प्रभु तमे तो जीती गयाने मारे कर में हार संकट ने उपसर्गो ने तमे सहता हसता दुख पड़े तो कायर थईने वेठू रड़ता रड़ता प्रभु तमे पेले पार गयाने हूँ तो डूबू मजदार प्रभु तमे तो जीती गयाने मारे कर में हार मारे कर में हार सीती नो पद पामवत में साची साधना की थी दुनिया नी रिद्धि मेड़वा में तो विराधना की दी गोथा खाई रहो छू उतर जो भव पार प्रभु तमे तो जीती गया ने मारे कर में मारे कर में जय जिनेन्द्र
ओवर टू रितेश
Thank you so much, Justice Bhai and Nalini Bhai. Moving to the next meeting agenda, as I mentioned in the presentation about Parshala Kids Ingredients Project. So as discussed in the last meeting, what we have decided is, you know, we have reserved few minutes for Parshala Kids to showcase their work related to this project. So every meeting, for next couple of meetings, you know, we'll have those kids coming and presenting their work. So for that, let me hand over to Rita Ben and she'll let us know the next steps. So what do you recommend?
Thank you, Ritesh Bhai. Jai Jinendra, everyone. So Kurvi and I have been working with this ingredients project with the Mahavir Group Parshala students. And last meeting, the September meeting, we already provided the objective behind the project as well as the background. So we won't repeat that today. And last meeting, if you were not here, we had two of our students already present. Their project, Vanshi and Anshi, presented on ice cream as well as skincare products. And today we will continue with two more students, as Ritesh Bhai mentioned. Today's presenters are Aro Parekh and Monish Shah. So without further ado, we will start with their presentations, starting with Aro first. So Purvi, if you have a comment to add, you can do that. Otherwise, if you could please share Aro's presentation.
I'm going to go ahead and share Aro's presentation.
Okay, thank you.
My name is Aro. And I did a review on candies that are vegetarian and non-vegetarian.
There is some. Is everybody muted?
So I think Vijay Bhai Jain, if you can mute yourself, that would be good. Thank you.
Aro, can you start again, please?
Yeah. Jay Jinendra, my name is Aro Parekh, and I did my ingredients project on candies that are vegetarian and non-vegetarian, and it's especially important right now as Halloween is right around the corner. Next slide, please. Yeah. So the outline of today's presentation, I'll start with the current state right now. We'll move to some non-vegetarian candies, some common ingredients used in those non-vegetarian candies, and then vegetarian and vegan candies or alternatives for vegans or vegetarians. Next slide, please. So today, it is crazy in this day and age that many candies contain animal products. With all the technology available, combined with the fact that we have such an advanced society, we should be able to find other alternatives. Some companies have realized this, and they're catering to some of their vegetarian and vegan consumers now. And as I said before, Halloween is right around the corner. So this is very useful for people giving out candy, or if you're getting any candy, make sure you get the vegan ones or vegetarian ones and stay safe. Next slide, please. So these are some candies that are not vegetarian and why. So gummy bears, candy corn, gummy worms, Nerds, Altoids, marshmallows, Jell-O, Rice Krispie Treats, Pop-Tarts, and Junior Mints all have gelatin, and Junior Mints and Red Candy both have ingredients that come from the Pinocchio beetle, or the Cochineal beetle. For Junior Mints, it's the shiny glaze, and for any red candy, it's the red dye that's from the Cochineal beetle. And whenever you purchase candy, just make sure that you read the ingredients. And soon, coming in the next slide, you'll see some of the names you can look for to know that if candies are not vegetarian. Next slide, please. So, as I mentioned, a lot of the candies before have gelatin. So what is gelatin? Gelatin is a base or powder that is made from animal skin, tissue, or even bones, and it's used in candy to make the ingredients stick together and make the candy chewy. And a lot of the candies I mentioned before have gelatin, and now you know why they use gelatin. Next slide, please. What is a cochineal beetle? So the cochineal beetle is an insect with scales but no wings. It's 1/3 of an inch long and lives on cacti. And they're used for their dye and shiny waxing. And as I said before, we're getting into some alternative names. If you read the ingredients, there might be ingredients named carmine, natural red 4, or E120. All of these come from the cochineal beetle. So if you see those, steer clear of those. And the way cochineal beetles, their shiny glaze and red dye are found and used is they're boiled or they're dried and then they're crushed up and they're used in red candy for that dye, and their shiny glaze remains when we do that. Next slide, please. Now on a better note, these are some candies that are safe for vegetarians and vegans. Airheads, Jolly Ranchers, Twizzlers, Smarties, Swedish Fish, Skittles, Sweet Tarts, Sour Patch Kids, Lemon Heads, Dots, and Dum Dums. And some of the candies I mentioned that are non-vegetarian, like marshmallows and Pop-Tarts, do have other alternatives that are vegetarian and vegan. But again, look at the ingredients. Next slide. And these are my sources. Thank you.
Great job, Arav. So then we move on to Monish. Monish, and before that, if anybody has any questions for Arav, quick, a couple, otherwise we'll move on. Okay. Thank you, Arav. Monish, are you ready?
Yeah, I'm just going to share.
Okay, thank you.
Wait, so can you see it?
Yes, we can.
Okay.
Go ahead.
Okay, so Jai Jinendra, my name is Monish. And so our class had done an ingredients project, and my topic was on chocolates.
Video you want to do it for you? Vegetarian chocolates, no, it's vegan chocolate.
And so basically, this is my outline, and I'm just going to walk you through some vegetarian chocolates, vegan chocolates, chocolates with eggs and egg whites, chocolates with rennet or gelatin, and I'm going to explain what rennet and gelatin are. And so basically, I'm just going to tell you some chocolates that we can eat and some chocolates we should avoid as James. So these are some vegetarian chocolates, and by vegetarian, I mean the exclusion of meat and other animal products except milk. And so some examples I have are Hershey chocolate, such as Hershey bars, Hershey kisses, and white chocolate, Kit Kats, Twix, Reese's, M&M's, Tootsie Rolls, and Ferrero Rochers. And so a fun fact about Twix is that they had decided in 2007 they would no longer be vegetarian and would have eggs. But then in 2012, they decided to change it back and they would once again be vegetarian. And so these are some vegan chocolates. And by vegan, I mean vegetarian, plus the exclusion of all animal products, including dairy, honey, gelatin, etc. And so most dark chocolates are vegan. And some examples I've written are Lindt dark chocolate, Cadbury dark chocolate, Daza dark chocolate, vegan Ferrero Rochers. And they decided since May 2007 they would give an option, but they also have a vegetarian option and a number of others. And in addition to dark chocolates, some may be labeled as vegan. You just have to look for them in the stores. And so now I'm going to tell you some chocolates we should not eat as Jains, because as Jains, we believe in nonviolence and ahimsa. And so these are chocolates with eggs or egg whites. And they are Toblerone, which contains egg whites, Three Musketeers, Milky Way, and Snickers. And so these are only a few examples I've found, but there are many more. And so these are non-vegetarian chocolates with rennet and gelatin. And so they are Mars Bars, Cadbury Dairy Milk Dame, and Junior Mints, which contain gelatin. And so now I'm going to explain what rennet and gelatin are. And so rennet is an enzyme that is derived from the stomach lining of a calf. And gelatin is a mixture of peptides and proteins produced by partial hydrolysis of collagen extracted from the skin, bones, and connective tissues of animals, such as domesticated cattle, chicken, pigs, and fish. And so I had chosen this topic because I wanted to help others not make the same mistakes as I had in the past, and because I like eating chocolate sometimes. And so as Aravind mentioned about candy and Halloween, I think it's important to remember these things, and I hope I've helped you learn something about chocolates that you should eat and ones you should avoid. Thank you.
Thank you, Monish. Anybody have any questions for Monish?
I have a question.
Okay, go ahead.
Are Ferrero Rochers vegan?
So they have an option as vegan. You just have to look for them. Not all of them are vegan. They just have a specific option you have to look for.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.
I have a comment for
Monish said, oh, sorry. I said, as Monish said, just check the ingredients on the label.
Thank you, Peter Ben. I have a comment for Monish and Arav. Wonderful job. I think it's very educational for all of us. And with the Halloween coming up, although it's COVID time, I think it's important both for children to be aware of this, but also for adults, if they're going to be handing out candies, they should be aware of what they're handing out. Thank you so much.
Yeah, that's a great point. Thank you.
Yes, and I just want to add that, especially what Dr. Raya said, and also that make your community and your friends aware as well, because I'm sure that if they knew that there were bugs in those candies and how many bugs are killed just to produce that dye, they would stop eating that as well and giving those out, as well as gelatin. I know that there are other people of other faiths that also do not eat gelatin or would not promote that. Thank you.
Ritesh Bhai, I think over to you. We are done with the presentations. Thank you to Arav and Monish again. Great job.
Yeah, thank you, Arav and Monish. Definitely, you know, as everybody said, it is definitely helpful. And coming Halloween is, you know, nearby. This is definitely, you know, very informative. So thank you for that. Now, moving to the next meeting agenda item, that is today's discourse. The fear of COVID is changing our psychology. So that is that is very well proved, and it has an immediate impact on our mental health. Considering that, committee has decided to come up with something related to this. So that is why, you know, we come up with this discourse around mental health. And for that, we have invited external speaker, Deepika Gala. So she has an excellent background and amazing skills around this. So let me ask our Vice President Rajan Cheda to introduce her and then hand over to Deepika ji to begin the discourse. Over to you, Rajan.
Thank you, Ritesh. Jai Jirendra, everyone. Hope you all are doing great. As we are all experiencing extraordinarily unusual times that we never anticipated, it has become crucial to stay focused, balanced, and take care of our mental health even more so. We are all very much aware of our well-being, and I believe we are taking all measures to keep our mental wellness, but we certainly need reminder often. In keeping that in mind, we have invited very talented Ms. Deepika Gala as our mental health coach in our today's session. Ms. Deepika Gala has procured her master's in philosophy from University of Mumbai. Ms. Deepika Gala specialized in teaching philosophy of Jainism. She masters in conducting meditation program, and she conducts various diverse workshops for adults as well as teenagers. Ms. Deepika Gala is independent meditation coach and spiritual trainer. She brings her skills in emotional management, life training, and mentorship. It is my honor to present her today and guide us through her knowledge on meaning and importance of mental health, identify proper mental health conditions, teaching of restoring mental health balance, and meditation. So without further delay, I would like to hand over to Ms. Deepika Gala. Ms. Deepika Gala, over to you. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Rajan, for such a wonderful introduction. And the kids, very well done. It was really much more efforts that you put into this presentations. So congratulations to both of you. And of course, their parents who would have helped them. And I'm grateful to JSCNC for giving me this opportunity to conduct this session for all of you. And I'm really honored to have all of you together in this journey. So let's start with what is to be understood by mental health. So I'll share a presentation and let us see how things are with us. Can you see my I hope all of you can see my presentation. So it is about mental health in current situation and how meditation can help us through this difficult time. So for this is going to be an interactive session. So all of you, please keep your mobiles handy. You will be asked to do certain tasks and go ahead with it. So let's start. Okay, so for this presentation and to interact with me, because we are all at different locations, it will be great that we can use some platform. And I would request you all to go to menti.com and type the code 1860695. So the question on the screen is, what are your expectations for today's session? And you can rate your... you can give your inputs on this question, and you will be able to see it on the screen as well. Wow, that's great. Yes, very good. Okay, so some of you are wanting to learn meditation, some of you want to manage mental health, okay. Some of you want to go to learn deeper meditation. Okay, great. Yes, okay. So the scores are changing. Okay, most of you want to learn about mental health. Great. Okay, now it's almost going to be balanced. Meditate, mental health. Okay, very good. So I think if one or two people are still voting, then I can hold for a few seconds and then let's see how we can go ahead. So all of you who have this expectation to learn meditation, yes, that will be fulfilled. And you, all of you, those who want to know how to manage mental health, I will try my best to show you the way. And of course, all those who are already meditating and want to go deeper into meditation, for all of them also, there are techniques that I will be sharing. So definitely, this is going to be a journey where we all will learn something together. Okay, so now again, the scores are changing. So all of you want to learn how to meditate, that's on the high. Okay, and manage mental health is going side by side along with it. Deeper meditation, of course, as you will keep doing it, you will definitely learn it. So let's go ahead with the next one. Okay, still people are voting, so I'll wait. Okay, so most of you want to know how to meditate. Want to learn how to meditate. તમને બધાને એ શીખવું છે કે કેવી રીતે મેડિટેશન કરવાનો. ઓકે ચલો આઈ વિલ પ્રોસીડ ટુ ધ નેક્સ્ટ સ્લાઇડ. ઓકે ઓકે નાઉ અગેન અ ટાસ્ક ફોર ઓલ ઓફ યુ, હાઉ વુડ યુ ડિસ્ક્રાઇબ હેલ્થ ઇન વન વર્ડ? તમને જો એક શબ્દમાં હેલ્થ વિશે કંઈક કહેવું હોય તો તમે કઈ રીતે એને ડિસ્ક્રાઇબ કરશો, કઈ રીતે એનું વર્ણન કરશો? સો યુ કેન અગેન ગો ટુ menti.com, યુઝ ધ સેમ કોડ એન્ડ ટાઈપ જસ્ટ બિલો ધીસ ક્વેશ્ચન. આઈ થિંક યુ વિલ બી ગેટિંગ ટુ ચાન્સીસ ઇન ફેક્ટ. ઓકે, હેપી, પીસફુલ, હેલ્ધી, વાવ, વેલ્થ, વાવ, ફુલ અવેરનેસ, વન્ડરફુલ, ફીલિંગ એનર્જાઇઝ્ડ, lively, anxiety less, okay, peace, precious, important, full awareness, happy, content, peaceful, quality, wow, wonderful, wow. So I think you, most of you know what health is all about. I don't think I need to take this session further. Okay. Quality, precious, less stress, feeling energized, important, peace, content, everything. Wow. Full awareness, wealth, good, less stress, quality, anxiety less, lively. I think I've read most of it. If you are still voting and still writing, please go ahead. I'm waiting for you. Very interesting answers, aren't they? And I think most of us will agree that we all really want this, aren't we? We all want to have this in our life. We all want to have a content, healthy, peaceful, wealthy life with full awareness. We all want to have complete, energized and quality life, which is completely free from anxiety, free from all types of stress. Isn't it? We all want this. And the answers are in front of you. Okay, some more inputs. I can't find out. Let me see. Okay. I can't find out. So, anxiety less, everything, awareness. Yeah, I think I've read most of it. Maybe if I'm missing out on something, it is in front of you. So please read and see what all we want. We really want this. All of us, in spite of doing X, Y, Z things, we all ultimately want this. We all want to have a peaceful, happy life. And let's see how we can have that. So, chalo, have apni journey ma agar chahiye. So, yes. This is a quote from Dr. Bach. Dr. Edward Bach was a bacteriologist and he researched on flowers, and he came up with different flower energies which can heal. So he says that there is no true healing unless there is a change in outlook, peace of mind and inner happiness. And as you all just now answered, it is the same thing that he says, right? So if we are looking for health, if we are looking for healing, what we must look at is the peace of mind and the inner happiness. And that only can give us complete healing, complete health. And when we say about health and healing, he's yet not talking about the physical health. See, I would like to point out this to you, that what he is talking about is the inner health, inner happiness, mental awareness, and where all our emotions, feelings will come up with. So Dr. Bhat jare vat kare che ke healing athva health ni vat kare che, tyare koi pan apna sharir ni vastuo vishe vat nathi karta ke sharir kevu hovu joye, pan e ke che ke apni pase shanti hase ane apna andar ni jo khushi hase to automatically apni potani jate j enu healing thatu rahese. So ane તમે બધાએ જે આન્સર્સ આપ્યા ને એમાં પણ આ જ વસ્તુ આવી કે વી ઓલ વોન્ટ વેન વી ટોક અબાઉટ હેલ્થ ઇટ્સ ઓલ અબાઉટ ઇનર હેલ્થ ઇટ્સ ઓલ અબાઉટ પીસ ઇટ ઇઝ અબાઉટ કન્ટેન્ટમેન્ટ ઇટ ઇઝ ઓલ અબાઉટ હેવિંગ નો સ્ટ્રેસ અથવા ઇફ એટ ઓલ ઇફ આઈ હેવ સ્ટ્રેસ આઈ શુડ બી એબલ ટુ મેનેજ દેટ અને અલ્ટિમેટલી આઈ શુડ હેવ દેટ પીસ ઓફ માઇન્ડ સો લેટ્સ પ્રોસીડ ઓકે આઈ હેવ એકચ્યુઅલી આન્સર્ડ ધીસ But now it's your turn to answer. Do you know that you can transform your health by managing your emotions? Okay. So most of you know it. Okay. Some want to know it. Okay. Yes. Great. સો મારા ખ્યાલથી બધાને ઓલમોસ્ટ ખબર જ છે કે યસ આઈ કેન મેનેજ ઇફ આઈ મેનેજ માય ઇમોશન્સ આઈ કેન મેનેજ માય હેલ્થ એન્ડ ધોઝ હુ આર વન્ડરિંગ દે વિલ ઓલ્સો નો ઓવર યુ નો હાઉ વી એઝ વી પ્રોસીડ દે વિલ ઓલ્સો સે દેટ ઓકે આઈ નો નાવ હાઉ ટુ મેનેજ માય ઇમોશન્સ એન્ડ ડેફિનેટલી આઈ નો હાઉ ટુ મેનેજ માય હેલ્થ ઓકે સો મેઇનલી વોટ વી આર લુકિંગ એટ ઇઝ ઇફ વી કેન મેનેજ અવર ઇમોશન્સ વેલ ડેફિનેટલી વી કેન ટેક કેર ઓફ અવર હેલ્થ કમ્પ્લીટલી ઓકે સ્ટીલ વોટિંગ ગોઈંગ ઓન Great. Okay. Yes. So most of you know that, and you all agree that, yes, I know that I can manage my emotions and I can transform. And those who want to know, let's proceed with the next one and understand what do we mean by that. So here now, again, some more exercises for you. Okay. This is going to be like this. Huh? So bear with me. So mention some of the emotions that you know of. So you can talk about maybe I'll give you a simple emotion of happiness, joy, and you go on, please. All the different emotions that you know of, please write them down. I want this blackboard to be completely filled with those names of the emotions. Anger, sadness, happiness, positive, negative. Okay, fruitful, joy, fear, greed, ego, okay, anxiety, sensitivity, envy, worried, love, happiness I read earlier, yes, it's getting full, very good. Keep doing it. Wow, materialistic, peaceful, bliss. Yes, not able to help. Okay, very nice. Then good, thankful. Yes. Then there was one more that I just about to read and positive. Yes, worried, pain. Yeah. Content. Then we have good I read, not able to help also I read, and success. Okay, wow, so many emotions, so many of them, so many. Pain, not able to help. Okay, I think I may be miss great gratitude, I may be missing out on something now, it seems. Sadness, then succeed, sad, happiness, thankful, yeah, fruitful. I think most of them I have read. In case if I missed out, you know what those emotions are because they are in front of you. Okay, so we all know these different emotions, right? We know that all of these emotions continuously are playing in our mind. So at one point of time, we may be feeling jealousy about someone, and at the other point, we may be feeling envious, then we may get into fear. So all these emotions continuously, keep coming into our space, keep coming into our body, and we are completely engaged in all of these things. So now my next question is, because these are different emotions, right? Now, if we were to tackle each one, it would be a little difficult in the sense that we will need some help and we need to take care of, quite a lot of factors. But if we can narrow them down, where can we narrow them down to? So if I were to say all these emotions, they majorly fall into, okay, let's do an exercise for that. Okay. So at this point, I would ask each one of you to just sit straight like you would sit for a meditation, and with your back completely straight, your chin completely parallel to the ground, your eyes focused at the point which is in front of you. The head should not be up or down. It should be completely parallel to the ground, and gently close your eyes. Now, take the emotion of fear at this point. And as you're thinking about it, right now you're thinking about it, as you utter this word fear, just observe what happens to your body. How is the body feeling when you think of this word known as fear? At the same time, as you're observing your body, also check what happens to your heart, what happens to your muscles, what happens to your entire breath. Now, with your eyes, with your eyes still closed, I would request you to now focus on your breath. Observe your breath. You had observed your body, now observe your breath. As you're observing your breath, think of your birthday, which was celebrated so beautifully that you really enjoyed it. Get into all the details of that birthday. How was it? How many people were there? Or were you alone and you still celebrated? What all happened on that day? And now, at this point, as you are completely in that thought of your well-spent birthday, observe your body. How is your body now? Also, observe your breath. How is it? Just observe it. We are not going into any logic. We are not going into any kind of questions with the breath. Simply observe. How is it now? And as you're observing, now compare. Is it different from the earlier one? The experience of fear, is it different from that one? Is your body feeling different from what it was earlier? As you're comparing, make the note of both these impressions. What happened initially, pehla sua tu, when you were thinking about fear, dar, ane have kevu che, when you're thinking about a well-spent birthday. Make the note of your bodily awareness, bodily impressions. શરીરમાં શું ચેન્જીસ આવ્યા એની નોટ કરી રાખો, અને તમારા શ્વસનમાં શ્વાસમાં કયા ચેન્જીસ આવ્યા એનો નોટ કરી રાખો. સો ચેક યોર બ્રેથ, ચેક યોર બોડી. એન્ડ વિથ ધીઝ ઇમ્પ્રેશન્સ ઇન યોર માઇન્ડ ફ્રેશ, જસ્ટ બ્રિંગ યોર બોથ પામ્સ ટુગેધર, યોર આઈઝ સ્ટીલ ક્લોઝડ, ડુ નોટ ઓપન ધેમ યેટ. રબ ધેમ અગેન્સ્ટ ઈચ અધર્સ, બંને હાથની હથેળીને એકબીજા સાથે ઘસવાની છે, અને ધીરેથી તમારી હથેળીને તમારી આંખો પર રાખવાની છે. કીપ યોર વોર્મ પામ્સ ઓન યોર આઈઝ એન્ડ જેન્ટલી વેન યુ આર રેડી, જ્યારે તમે તૈયાર હો ત્યારે આંખો ખોલવાની છે. સો વેન યુ આર રેડી જસ્ટ જેન્ટલી ઓપન યોર આઈઝ. Though this slide is not here, I want to ask you all, is your body feeling different? Your breath feeling different? And how is it? How is your connection to your own self? તમારું પોતાના સાથેનું અનુસંધાન કેવું છે હમણાં? So, let's move ahead. So, અગર એની ઇમોશન, કોઈ પણ ઇમોશન હશે, એને અગર આપણે કેટેગરાઇઝ કરવું હશે તો આપણે એને બે ઇમોશનમાં અથવા બે કેટેગરીમાં નાખી શકીએ. વી કેન ડિવાઇડ ધેમ ઇન ટુ ટુ કેટેગરીઝ, એન્ડ ધોઝ ટુ મેજર કેટેગરીઝ આર ફીલિંગ હેપી ઓર ફીલિંગ સેડ. સો ઓર અરાધર આઈ શુડ હેવ રિટન ફીલિંગ ગુડ ઓર ફીલિંગ બેડ ઓર નોટ ફીલિંગ ગુડ. સો એની ઇમોશન, લેટ્સ ગો બેક ટુ ધ પ્રીવિયસ સ્લાઇડ્સ. So, any of these emotions, anger, pain, we can say, I'm not feeling good about it. If it is love, joy, I feel good about it. So, any emotion you can majorly categorize into two major categories. They will have their own intensities. Darek emotion nu potani ek alag hase, enu apne kahe eni prakarta. But in spite of that, every emotion will be categorized into two main categories, that is feeling good or not feeling good. So I really like it and I don't like it. These are the two major emotions in which every emotion will fit. There is no midway, there is no other thing than this. So now we know that there are two different types of categories of emotions. One which feels good, the other one which does not feel good. One which makes us better, the other one which does not make us feel good. So if we now know that there are two categories, and if fear comes in the category of not feeling good, now what is our task? Our task is to convert that into feeling good. Simple. Is it? Let's try. It is. So let's wait. And let's go ahead. So how to know the emotional state? Actually, just now you did it. Now you know it, in fact. How will you know that you are feeling good or you are not feeling good? I shouldn't have asked this question, right? You all know it. Because immediately, as soon as you are in fear, you don't feel good at all. But the problem with us is that we don't realize that I'm not feeling good. So if I categorize not feeling good into negative emotion and feeling good into positive emotion, when there is negative or positive emotion, we can't differentiate when we are in that emotion. That is the problem. There is no other problem with us. Our body also knows it well. Our body will also immediately tell us. Breath will also try to tell us, okay, this is how you're feeling right now. But the problem is that we do not align to our breath. We do not align to our body. And that is why we don't know what state are we in. So we don't know whether are we thinking negative thoughts or are we thinking positive thoughts. And emotions have the, you know, very specific way of what they will do. You know, as soon as some emotion is there, automatically our thought process will start working on that emotion. So it's very difficult at times that we come back to our. સો જેવો કોઈ ઇમોશન ઉત્પન્ન થયું તો એના પાછળની થોટ પ્રોસેસ એટલી ફાસ્ટ થવા લાગે કે વી ડુ નોટ રિયલાઇઝ કે આપણે હમણાં નેગેટિવ વિચારી રહ્યા છીએ અથવા હમણાં આપણે પોઝિટિવ વિચારી રહ્યા છીએ અને પછી આપણી પોતાની જાતને સેન્ટર કરવું એ ડિફિકલ્ટ હોય છે. સો ટુડે વોટ વી વિલ બી ડુઈંગ ઇઝ હાઉ ટુ સેન્ટર અવર ઓન સિસ્ટમ સો દેટ કોઈ પણ ઇમોશન હોય એને આપણે ઇઝીલી ટેકલ કરી શકીએ. ઓકે, ગુડ ટુ ગો, લેટ્સ પ્રોસીડ. I think I would like to see each one of you, so I'll stop share for some time. And yes, if there are some chats, I would like to address them. Are there any questions? Are there any anything that you want to please ask in the chat box? So I'll, if you are good to go, I'll proceed then. Shall I proceed? Please show thumbs up or something so that I know that you all are with me. Okay. Let's proceed. In case if you have to say something, please, you know, write a question mark in the chat box. So we will address that question. I mean, if some of you are not, you know, don't want to write in the chat box, then write question mark. So we will just ask you to speak. So let's proceed now. I'll start sharing again. Okay. Yes, you all see my screen, I hope. I can see my screen. So, if you want to understand my own emotion, where should I check? So, I should be checking with my body. I should be checking my breath. We just did this exercise. Any emotion, it will definitely give an impact on your body and on your breath. So if there are children around, they know very well how to convert negative emotion into a positive one. We have lost this ability. Somewhere, you know, we are forgetting how to connect to our body, how to connect to our breath, and how to deal with emotions. And that is the struggle that we all are having. Ke apna pase a tool hatu. Children, we knew કે કઈક પ્રોબ્લેમ આવ્યો કે તરત જ આપણે કઈક બીજી એક્ટિવિટી કરવા લાગીશું કે કઈક ને કઈક કરશું કે જેનાથી આપણું શરીર પણ સરસ થઈ જશે અને શ્વાસ પણ સરસ ચાલવા લાગશે. અને ધીરે 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 વી ગોટ ઇન ટુ સો મેની ડિફરન્ટ થિંગ્સ કે આપણે આ એબિલિટી ભૂલી ગયા. સો લેટ્સ ગેટ બેક ટુ દેટ એબિલિટી દેટ વી ઓલ હેવ. સો આપણે અગર આપણી શરીરને આપણા બ્રેથને સમજવું છે તો હાઉ વિલ વી ડૂ દેટ? અને એના સાથે આપણે અગર આપણા શરીરને શ્વાસને કોઈક ને કોઈક રીતે ઉપયોગમાં લાવવો છે જેનાથી આપણા ઇમોશન્સને આપણે હેન્ડલ કરી શકીએ તો આપણે આજે એ કરશું. સો લેટ્સ અન્ડરસ્ટેન્ડ અબાઉટ બોડી એન્ડ બ્રેથ બાય ધીસ મેડિટેટિવ એક્સરસાઇઝ. અગેન, યા, ધીસ ઇઝ અગેન ગોઈંગ ટુ બી, યુ નો, સમટાઈમ્સ યુ વિલ હેવ ટુ રાઇટ હિયર ઓર સમટાઈમ્સ યુ વિલ બી આસ્ક્ડ ટુ ક્લોઝ યોર આઈઝ. સો બી વિથ મી, બેર વિથ મી. So again, I would ask all of you to close your eyes one more time. And as you close your eyes, again, of course, the conditions remain the same. Your back should be straight, your chin parallel to the ground, your eyes earlier, I mean, you know, before you close your eyes, just focused on the point in front of you and gently close your eyes. Now, at this point in time, focus on your breath first. As you're breathing in and breathing out, observe your breath. Observe how is the breath going in and coming out. Shwas andar kai rite jai rahyo chhe ane bahar kai rite aavi rahyo chhe. શ્વાસમાં અત્યારે બ્રીધિંગ ઇન વધારે છે કે બ્રીધિંગ આઉટ વધારે છે? એઝ યુ આર બ્રીધિંગ ઇન એન્ડ બ્રીધિંગ આઉટ, ચેક વેધર યુ આર બ્રીધિંગ ઇન મોર ઓર બ્રીધિંગ આઉટ મોર. ઓબ્ઝર્વ હાઉ ડીપ ઇઝ યોર બ્રેથ. And and with your breath, also observe your body. How is your body at this moment? We just did an exercise before this where we thought about the fear. We also thought about a joyful experience. જ્યારે આપણે ડર વિશે અને એક આપણે ખુશીના પ્રસંગ વિશે આપણે વિચાર કર્યો ત્યારે આપણું શરીર આપણો શ્વાસ અલગ હતો. અત્યારે આપણે કંઈક નવું કરી રહ્યા છીએ ત્યારે શરીર કેવું છે, ત્યારે આપણો શ્વાસ કેવો ચાલી રહ્યો છે. Now at this point, again bring in the memory of incident that would have happened just before few days ago, which was related to corona, COVID. કોઈક એવું પ્રસંગ કે જેમાં કોરોના કે કોવિડ વિશેને તમને કઈ માહિતી મળી છે અથવા તમારા તમને કોઈક સર્કલમાં છે કે જેના વિશે તમને ખબર પડી છે. And check your body and check your breath. શરીરને જોવાનું છે, શ્વાસને જોવાનો છે. શરીરમાં અને શ્વાસમાં કયો ફરક આવ્યો? Now, એ મેમરીને, એ જે યાદ છે એને સાથે રાખીને જ તમે હમણાં કેટલો શ્વાસ લઈ રહ્યા છો એનાથી થોડોક ઊંડો શ્વાસ લેવાનો છે. Keeping this memory in your mind, take slightly deeper breath as compared to what you are breathing now. Do not force your body, do not exert. કોઈ પણ પ્રકારનું કોઈ પણ પ્રેશર આપણે શરીરને નથી આપવાનું. તમે શ્વાસ જો બે કાઉન્ટ માટે લેતા હો તો ફક્ત અઢી કાઉન્ટ લેવાનો છે. વધારે કોઈ પણ ઊંડો શ્વાસ બહુ ઊંડો લેવાની જરૂર નથી, થોડોક ઊંડો લેવાનો છે. એવા ત્રણ શ્વાસ લઈને શ્વાસ લેવાનો અને છોડવાનો. ફરીથી હવે શ્વાસને જોવાનો છે. હમણાં તમારો શ્વાસ હવે કેવો ચાલે છે? તમારા મગજમાં એ મેમરી છે અને મેમરી હંમેશા હમણાં યાદ જ રાખવાની છે. યુ હેવ ટુ કીપ ઇન માઇન્ડ ધ મેમરી ઓફ રીસન્ટ ઇન્સિડન્ટ અબાઉટ કોરોના કોવિડ વિચ ઇઝ ફ્રેશ ઇન યોર માઇન્ડ એન્ડ યુ હેવ જસ્ટ ટેકન અ ડીપ બ્રેથ. One more time, keeping this memory in your mind, take slightly deeper breath for three more breaths. Haji vadu tron shwas mate thoda unda shwas levana chhe. Tame hamna jetlo shwas leta ho enathi thodo kundo, bahu koi j pressure nathi apvano sharir ne. ત્રણ શ્વાસ થાય એટલે ફરીથી શ્વાસને જોવાનો છે. અગેન કીપિંગ ઇન માઇન્ડ ધ રીસન્ટ મેમરી ઓફ કોરોના ઓર કોવિડ. ફરીથી અગેન એઝ યુ આર કીપિંગ ઇન માઇન્ડ ધ રીસન્ટ મેમરી, ચેક યોર બ્રેથ વન મોર ટાઈમ. હાઉ ઇઝ ઇટ? ઇઝ ઇટ ડિફરન્ટ? હાઉ ઇઝ યોર બોડી નાઉ? ઇઝ ઇટ ડિફરન્ટ? શરીરમાં કંઈ પરિવર્તન આવ્યું? શ્વાસમાં કંઈ પરિવર્તન આવ્યું? ફરીથી હજી એકવાર કીપિંગ ધીસ મેમરી ઇન યોર માઇન્ડ ફ્રેશ વન મોર ટાઈમ. Slightly deeper breath as compared to what you're breathing now. તમે હમણાં જે શ્વાસ લઈ રહ્યા છો એનાથી થોડો ઊંડો શ્વાસ લેવાનો છે, છોડવાનો છે, લેવાનો છે, છોડવાનો છે. one more time. Check your body, check your breath. Again, check that memory. How is your body now for this memory? આજે યાદ હતી જે હમણાંનો કોઈ રીસેન્ટ ઇન્સિડન્ટ થયો છે એના વિશેની જે યાદ હતી એના સાથે હવે શરીર કેવી રીતે કોપ કરી રહ્યું છે? હાઉ ઇઝ ધ બોડી બિકમિંગ વિથ રિસ્પેક્ટ ટુ ધીસ મેમરી? Be aware of your body, be aware of your thought, be aware of your breath. Now, bring both your palms together, keeping your eyes closed. આંખોને બંધ રાખીને હથેળીઓને એકબીજાની સાથે લાવવાની છે. બંને હથેળીઓને એકબીજા સાથે ઘસવાની છે. અને ધીરેથી આંખો ઉપર તમારી ગરમ હથેળીઓને મૂકવાની છે. કીપ બોથ યોર આર્મ્સ ઓન યોર આઈઝ. જેન્ટલી વેન યુ આર રેડી ઓપન યોર આઈઝ. સો બી ઇન ધ સ્પેસ ફોર સમ ટાઈમ, બી વિથ યોર સેલ્ફ. Check now, what was the body's reaction initially and how is it now? જ્યારે શરૂઆતમાં મેં જ્યારે આ શબ્દ કીધો હશે કે આ ઇન્સિડન્ટ વિશે વાત કરી ત્યારે અને હમણાંમાં શરીરમાં કેટલો પરિવર્તન આવ્યો, કેટલો બદલાવ આવ્યો? બી અવેર ઓફ ઇટ. નાવ I would ask all of you to let me know, how is your breath? Has it changed? And has the state of mind changed? Again, go to Mentimeter and with the code on this question, please vote. Tamara shwas ma ketlu parivartan aavyu, tamara state of mind ma kai badlav aavyo. સો બ્રેથમાં બદલાવ આવ્યો, શ્વાસમાં પણ બદલાવ આવ્યો. ધેર ઇઝ ધ બ્રેથ હેઝ ચેન્જ્ડ એન્ડ સ્ટેટ ઓફ માઇન્ડ ઓલ્સો હેઝ ચેન્જ્ડ. ઓકે, થેન્ક યુ ફોર યોર શેર્સ. ઓકે, યસ, સો મોસ્ટ ઓફ યુ આર ઓબ્ઝર્વિંગ ધેટ બ્રેથ હેઝ ચેન્જ્ડ and your mind state of mind has also changed. When I'm talking about state of mind, what you had started with, jare tumne shuruaat mein me akidu ase to thodu em lagyo ase ke avi baat kem, but then now how is your body, how is your mind when you are thinking about that incident? Okay, so as our breath changes our body, it also has the capacity to change our state of mind. Apna shwas badlaye etle automatically apna sharir ma pan badlav avshe ane jevo sharir ma badlav avshe eni sathe sathe j athva enathi pan even pehla apna man na je parinamo che man ma je vicharo udbhave che ema pan badlav ava lagshe. So have can I say that our breath, apne 3 ke 4 alag alag situations ma gaya, we went into a very happy situation, we went into a very not very happy situation, we also checked when it was a recent incident. So can you say that our breath indicates our physical and emotional mental state? Can we say so? Okay, yes. Okay. So the key is to be aware of the breath. આપણા શ્વાસ પ્રત્યે સભાન થવાનું છે, આપણા શ્વાસ કેવા ચાલી રહ્યા છે એ જોતા રહેવાનું છે. અને ઇનફેક્ટ કોઈ પણ શાસ્ત્રોમાં જોશો તો હંમેશા શ્વાસ એટલે પ્રાણાયામ પર સૌથી વધારે ભાર આપેલો હશે, કે જે શરૂઆતની સ્ટેજ છે એના માટે બેસ્ટ ઇઝ દેટ યુ ટેક કેર ઓફ યોર બ્રેથ. સો ઇફ વી ટોક અબાઉટ અન્ડરસ્ટેન્ડિંગ અવર બ્રેથ, then automatically we are understanding our physical condition, we are also understanding our mental emotional state. Now if we say if our breath can indicate our physical emotional state, and which we already have done, can I also say that our breath can also change our physical, emotional, mental state? Because if we can control our breath, automatically we are controlling quite a lot of emotions that are around us, that whatever we are made up of. Apna sharir ni sathe apno shwas che, apna sharir ni sathe apna emotions sankdayela che. Ek jagah badlav avse to badhe thikane badlav avanu chalu thai jashe. So breath ne jo agar apne channelize kari shakya, બ્રેથ આખરે છે શું? લેટ અસ અન્ડરસ્ટેન્ડ ધેટ. આપણે સમજીએ છીએ કે બ્રેથ એટલે ખાલી એર છે. ઇટ ઇઝ જસ્ટ મેડ અપ ઓફ ઓક્સિજન, નાઇટ્રોજન, કાર્બન ડાયોક્સાઇડ એન્ડ ઓલ ઓફ ધેટ. અપાર્ટ ફ્રોમ ધેટ, બ્રેથ ઓર એર ઇઝ કમ્પ્લીટલી વાઇટલ ફોર્સ. ઇટ ઇઝ એનર્જી ઇન ઇટ સેલ્ફ, પ્રાણ શક્તિ છે. ઇટ ઇઝ પ્રાણ. સો એઝ વી આર બ્રીધિંગ ઇન, વોટ વી આર ડુઈંગ, વી આર બ્રીધિંગ ઇન ધ પ્રાણ, allowing that pran to reach out to each and every cell. Any condition, when we are fearful, when we are in anger, what happens to our body? We breathe very quickly. Why is it so? Because in that state, the body is trying to take more and more pran by breathing in more and more. Now, if at that point of time, if we can allow our body to deep breathe, automatically we are providing it with each and, you know, with for each and every cell the energy that it needs. A samay, when we are in anger, when we are fearful, our body tries to protect us completely. Apanne sambhalini rakhva mange che. So what it does, baddi jetli shakti che baddi bhegi kare che, it is trying to collect all that energy. Now in that state, if we can give us that energy, the body will be much more at ease. એવી સ્થિતિમાં આવી જશે કે જ્યાંથી એના માટે ઇઝી થઈ જશે. સો બાય ડુઈંગ ધીસ ફર્સ્ટ એક્સરસાઇઝ ધેટ વી ડીડ જસ્ટ નાઉ, ડીપ બ્રીધિંગ એક્સરસાઇઝ, વી સિમ્પલી જસ્ટ જેટલો બ્રેથ હતો એનાથી થોડોક ઊંડો કર્યો. વી જસ્ટ ડીડ ડીપ બ્રીધિંગ એઝ કમ્પેર ટુ વોટ વી વેર બ્રીધિંગ અર્લિયર. એન્ડ બાય ડુઈંગ સો, વોટ હેપન, અવર એન્ટાયર બોડીલી અવેરનેસ શિફ્ટેડ, બીકોઝ ઈચ એન્ડ એવરી સેલ સ્ટાર્ટેડ ગેટિંગ ધ નોટ ઓનલી ઓક્સિજન બટ ધ prana, that is the life force energy. And because we get that life force energy, it is much more easy for the cells to rejuvenate themselves, also the mental state to become much more healthier. So if I say so, this was the simplest tool that is one can use any time during the day. Breathe, not only breathe, focus on your breath, focus on deep breathing. So more and more deep breathing, automatically the body will become so strong, its immunity power will become so strong that you can fight anything and everything, because ultimately you are channelizing your own. Okay, just close your eyes for now, one more time. Let me know how is your body. Huh, think of anger, fear, jealousy, happy, joy, deep breathing. Everywhere the body reacted differently. Now you may open your eyes and please share with a big, big smile. So, did the body reacted differently for all these emotions? There may be a similar type of reaction. or some of you would have noticed there is slight different reaction of the body. Next time be aware of it. But now what I want to point out is, when I was saying negative emotion, was the body different than what I, when I said about deep breathing, was it different? Even talking about deep breath, the body feels so nice. And this is a simple tool that we all can use. It's with us. We don't have to go anywhere. Good. Let's proceed. Okay. So let's do one more. This is, again, we can identify and work on these emotions. So if we know that we are facing some difficult situation, immediately one can start breathing deeply. Also, one can regularly practice this so that ultimately when time comes, you will definitely be really, you know, acquainted to go through this. Now, one thing is identifying and working on. But what about a situation where you still want to change it completely? Deep breathing will work, definitely work. But if there was one more tool which can help you to every day get out, as soon as you get up, get rid of all those negative emotions, will that work for you? Okay, so let's go ahead. Let's do one more exercise. Again, this is also related to breath work. Okay, so just simply sit with your back straight, because this is a meditation class, so you'll have to do meditation again and again. So sit with your back straight, your chin parallel to the ground, your eyes focused on the point in front of you, and when you are ready, gently close your eyes. Now, as you're breathing in and breathing out, observe your body. Observe how your body feels. We have learned something. The body has memory of it. The body knows how to practice this very well. It is going to continue practicing. And this is stored in your memory, stored in your body memory. How to deal with any emotion which is not working for you. And now, with your eyes closed, the same way as you did the deep breathing, take a little deeper breath. Slightly deeper and breathe out. Again, breathe in. Little deeper and breathe out. Breathe in. And breathe out. As you're breathing out, connect to each and every part of your body. Connect to your legs, connect to your abdomen, chest, back, your hands, neck area, your face, your head. As you're connected to your breath, as you're connected to your body, be aware of how the breath is going out. ઉચ્છવાસ કેવો ચાલે છે એ જોવાનો છે. શ્વાસ અને ઉચ્છવાસ. બ્રીધિંગ ઇન એન્ડ બ્રીધિંગ આઉટ. નાઉ એઝ યુ બ્રીધિંગ આઉટ, એઝ યુ આર કનેક્ટેડ ટુ ઈચ એન્ડ એવરી પાર્ટ ઓફ યોર બોડી, જસ્ટ રિયલાઇઝ that with every breath out, the energy which is not contributing to you, which can be negative thoughts, feelings, emotions, fear, anger, jealousy, envy. All these emotions are going out with your breath out. As you are exhaling, all these emotions are going out. And they're reaching your feet. From your feet, they're reaching Mother Earth. And as soon as they reach Mother Earth, they convert into contributive energy. ये पद्धतीज लागणियों विचारों नकारात्मक ऊर्जा तमारा शरीर माथी निकळीने तमारा पग सुधी पहुंचे छे. पग माथी ए तमारा धरती मा सुधी पहुंची रही छे. अने धरती सुधी पहुंचताज त्या एनर्जी धरती ने कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट करी रही छे. Breathe in and breathe out. શ્વાસ લેવાનો છે અને છોડવાનો છે. As you breathe out, all that is not contributing goes out of your system, goes out of your body, your aura, તમારા શરીરમાંથી, તમારા આભા મંડળમાંથી, બધેથી જે નકારાત્મક ઉર્જા છે બધી જ પગ દ્વારા ધરતી સુધી પહોંચી રહી છે. અને તમે જેવો શ્વાસ લો છો, આખા બ્રહ્માંડમાંથી તમને જેની જરૂર છે એ ઉર્જા તમારા સુધી આવી રહી છે. પોઝિટિવ કોન્ટ્રીબ્યુટિવ એનર્જી રીચિંગ ટુ યુ થ્રુ ધ યુનિવર્સ એઝ યુ આર બ્રીધિંગ ઇન. You're connected to Mother Earth and you're connected to the universe. એક તરફ તમે માં ધરતી સાથે સંકળાયેલા છો અને બીજી તરફ બ્રહ્માંડ સાથે સંકળાયેલા છો. Breathe out all that is not contributing, જેની હવે જરૂર નથી. બધું જ તમારા શરીરમાંથી, આભામાંથી, તમારી ઓરામાંથી નીકળી રહ્યું છે. ઓલ ઓફ દેટ વિચ ઇઝ નોટ કોન્ટ્રીબ્યુટિંગ ઇઝ લીવિંગ યોર સિસ્ટમ, યોર બોડી, યોર ઓરા. એન્ડ એઝ યુ બ્રીધ ઇન, ધ યુનિવર્સલ એનર્જી ફ્લોઝ ટુ યુ, રીચાર્જિંગ યોર બોડી, મેકિંગ ઇટ મોર એન્ડ મોર એનર્જેટિક. તમારા શરીરને વધુ ને વધુ શક્તિ આપી રહ્યું છે, ઉર્જા આપી રહ્યું છે. યુ ફીલ સો ફ્રેશ. બી અવેર ઓફ ઓલ દેટ નેગેટિવ એનર્જી ગોઈંગ આઉટ ઓફ યોર બોડી એન્ડ બી અવેર ઓફ ધ પોઝિટિવ કોન્ટ્રીબ્યુટિવ એનર્જી રીચિંગ ટુ યુ, ટુ યોર બોડી, ટુ યોર ઓરા. તમારા શરીરમાં આવી રહેલી ઉર્જાને જોવાની છે. લેટ ધીસ ફ્લો બી ઓબ્ઝર્વડ. હું થોડી ક્ષણો માટે કંઈ પણ નહીં કહું. આઈ વિલ નોટ સ્પીક ફોર ફ્યુ સેકન્ડ્સ. Please observe the flow of energy from the universe into your body, from your body into the Mother Earth. Observe this flow. As you are observing this flow, thank the universe, thank your breath, thank your body. And now, with your eyes still closed, bring both your palms together આંખો હજી પણ બંધ રાખીને બંને હથેળીઓને સાથે લાવવાની છે. રબ ધેમ અગેન્સ્ટ ઈચ અધર્સ, એકબીજા સાથે ઘસવાની છે અને ધીરેથી આંખો પર મૂકવાની છે. ઓબ્ઝર્વ હાઉ યુ આર. How is your body now? Is it feeling different from what it was earlier? Be in that space. Be aware of it. So these exercises help us not only to identify, also to change the state of our health. Because it's not just food or water, it's also the cause to rejuvenate. બ્રહ્માંડની જે શક્તિ છે એ લઈને પણ આપણે આપણી જાતને સૌથી વધારે હેલ્ધી કરી શકીએ છીએ. અને હંમેશા આપણી પાસે આ શક્તિઓ આપણી સાથે ને સાથે જ છે. વી ડોન્ટ હેવ ટુ ગો એની વેર. વી ડોન્ટ હેવ ટુ યુઝ એની યુ નો સ્પેશિયલ ઇન્સ્ટ્રુમેન્ટ્સ ઓર એનીથિંગ. ઇટ્સ અવર બોડી વિથ બેસ્ટ ઇન્સ્ટ્રુમેન્ટ. વી જસ્ટ નીડ ટુ બી અવેર and practice certain practices. That's it. If we do so, nothing can shake us, nothing can, you know, bother us at all. How are you all feeling now? I would like to have your answers in the next one. Let me know how are you now. Please write your answers here. Okay, breath has deepened, flow of energy could also be felt, one went deeper as compared to earlier one. Okay, the breath was deeper, okay, flow of energy was there. Thank you for sharing. It is really helpful to know that each one could feel something, and it is really such a beautiful technique that each one of you can easily, you know, adopt it and continuously practice this. Still voting, so I'll just wait for a few more seconds and then we will proceed. Let us understand and let us have the recap of what we did so far. Okay, if you have any questions, please write them in the chat box. Yes, there are. Okay. So, let us understand what was the difference, or let us recap what is exercise 1 and exercise 2. So, when to use exercise 1 and how to use it. Exercise 1 was about deep breathing. Okay, Jyoti says that our breath changes our emotions. Then Shashin Cheda says it was easy to observe the breath. For example, short, quick versus long, deep. When you ask to observe the body, how do you feel? Can you give some examples? Okay. It was easy to observe the breath. For example, okay, that is the same question. Okay, the question is how do you know? How are you feeling at the moment? Anytime, whenever you are, you want to know what exactly are you feeling, go to two main emotions, that is feeling good or feeling bad. Is your body feeling good about it or is it not feeling good about it? Whenever the body is feeling good, it will have expansion energy. It will be much more easier. Your breath will be smooth. શ્વાસ જે હશે એક સરખો ચાલશે, ડીપ હશે, ઇટ વિલ બી મચ મોર કમ્ફર્ટેબલ. શરીર પણ એકદમ કમ્ફર્ટની સિચ્યુએશનમાં હશે. વેન ધ body is not comfortable. If you are going through a difficult emotion, શરીર પણ કેવું થઈ જશે, થોડું જકડાયેલું હશે, બ્રેથ ફટાફટ ફટાફટ ચાલતા હશે, ઇવન બ્રેથમાં ઉપર નીચે થતું હશે, એક બ્રેથ નાનો એક મોટો, અચાનક તૂટી જશે વચ્ચે. ઓલ ધીઝ આર સાઇન્સ દેટ યોર બ્રેથ ઇઝ ટ્રાઇંગ ટુ કોમ્પેન્સેટ ફોર ધ એનર્જી. સો શરીર જે છે એ ઉર્જા આપી રહ્યું છે, શ્વાસ જે છે ઉર્જા આપવાની કોશિશ કરી રહ્યું છે. સો if you want to know exactly how feeling at the moment, always check your breath, check your body. Sharir ma su chali rahyu che, comfortable che ke nathi, is your body comfortable or is it trying feeling uncomfortable? If there is pain, if there is stiffness, if there is heaviness, all these are signs that body is not comfortable. Sharir ma kya dukhavo chalu thai jase athva thodu heavy lagva lagse. મોસ્ટલી ચેસ્ટમાં હેવી લાગે, હાર્ટ સાઈડ પર, હાર્ટમાં વધારે હેવી લાગવા લાગે, ઓર કોઈ કોઈક લોકોને ઇમિડિયેટલી કોઈ પેઇન સ્ટાર્ટ થઈ. સો ધીઝ આર ધ સિમ્પટમ્સ એન્ડ સાઇન્સ વિચ ટેલ યુ દેટ યોર બોડી ઇઝ નોટ એટ ઇઝ. વેન ધ બોડી ઇઝ નોટ એટ ઇઝ મીન્સ ડેફિનેટલી યુ આર નોટ ફીલિંગ ગુડ અબાઉટ ઇટ. ઇન ધ કરન્ટ ટાઈમ, ઇન ધેટ ટાઈમ સ્પેસ, યુ આર નોટ ફીલિંગ ગુડ. And that is what body trying to tell you. Body is trying to tell you that, okay, be aware. This is not what I'm like. I'm not liking this. So when your body is not in very good mood, or, you know, when we say apne pachi khabar pade, but then body tells you immediately. So always make it a habit to observe your body, to observe your breath. As you will observe your body and breath, automatically you will know how to change that. Now we have got two more tools. One was the deep breathing. So as soon as you are aware that something is not right with my breath or something is not right with my body, start breathing deeply. And for that you don't need to, you know, sit in a proper position. You can stand, or if you are lying down, in any position you can do that. The other person may not know also what you are doing. સામેવાળાને ખબર પણ નહીં પડે કે તમે શું કરી રહ્યા છો. જસ્ટ તમે જેટલો શ્વાસ લો છો એનાથી થોડો ઊંડો, સ્લાઇટલી ડીપર બ્રીધિંગ, ઓબ્ઝર્વ યોર બ્રેથ વન મોર ટાઈમ, અગેન ડીપ બ્રીથ, કમ બેક ટુ ઓબ્ઝર્વિંગ. ફોર એક્ઝામ્પલ, વેન વી હેવ પ્રેઝન્ટેશન, સે ફોર એક્ઝામ્પલ આઈ હેડ ધીસ પ્રેઝન્ટેશન ટુડે, વોટ વુડ આઈ ડૂ? આઈ વોઝ ઓલ્સો નર્વસ, આઈ વોઝ ઓલ્સો ગોઈંગ માય ટેન્શન. So I did deep breathing, because through deep breathing I could connect to my body well, that energy that was required. So if you have presentation, all the children who are listening, if you have something to present in the school, if you are exams, if you have to go out somewhere where you are not comfortable, continuously observe your breath, do deep breathing exercise. Simple tool. And no rocket science. You just breathe slightly deeper. Automatically, your body will start shifting. The energy around you will start shifting. You will get friends. The exam will be easy. See, like, you know, I'm right now having such a beautiful audience. So this is what happens when your breath is in alignment with your body. Okay. So when to use? Every moment you can use it. More you breathe deeply, more better your energy levels will be, and your physical health will be fantastic. So are you all with me till now? If you have any questions, please write a question mark, or if you want to speak. Yes,
hey Deepika, I have one question.
Shraddha Chheda. Yeah. yes
why we have so many thoughts where we are doing meditation?
Yeah, it is because we are so used to it, and we have yet to train our mind to become, reduce the thoughts. Now, whenever we sit for meditation, the initial stage would be where your breath is not even, your breath is going up and down, your breath is going, it's like, it's broken, all of that. there is a direct connection between breath and thought. So when you are breathing too heavily, there will be too many thoughts. So slowly, as we keep on practicing simple exercise like, you know, deep breathing also, gradually our breath will slow down. More the breath slows down, lesser the emotions and lesser the thoughts. A time will come, as we keep on practicing regularly, a time will come when we can really become, for a fraction of a second also, you know, without thoughts. And in fact, this state we get every day, twice at least. As soon as we get up in the morning, we are completely thoughtless. We don't know where we are, what we are. That is the meditation. That is the key. You know, if we can tap there, if we can sit there for some time, we are actually meditating. These are techniques, you know, to reach that stage. So every morning, as soon as you all get up, everyone should sit just for a few minutes or few, as much as the time permits. And of course, till you are, you have started thinking. If you have started thinking, you can use this exercise of deep breathing. So initial few moments are very precious. જે શરૂઆતનો જ્યારે આપણે હજી કંઈ અવેર જ મતલબ અવેર છીએ સી વી આર અવેર બટ વી આર નોટ હેવિંગ એની થોટ્સ ઇટ્સ સચ અ બ્યુટિફુલ સ્ટેટ ઓફ અર એક્ઝિસ્ટન્સ અને એ સ્ટેટમાં થોડી વાર બેસી રહેવાનું બસ કાંઈ નહીં કરવાનું એન્ડ આફ્ટર દેટ ઇફ યુ થિંક દેટ હવે પાછા વિચારવા લાગ્યા છે ને સ્ટાર્ટ ડીપ બ્રીધિંગ સો તમારા સવાલને હજી જો અગર હું આગળ એક્સટેન્ડ કરું ઇફ આઈ વર ટુ એક્સટેન્ડ you know, answer to this question, if we are having too many thoughts, what should we do? We should simply practice deep breathing. Continuous practice of deep breathing will help you reduce your thought processes, and also it will help you in maintaining and balancing emotions. We just did this exercise, right? Where we were continuously thinking about something. We were so affected by that. And as we did deep breathing, then we did some other thing, automatically that difference was noticed. We could all feel, and I can really say that each one of you could feel that difference was there as you continued this practice. And we just did maybe three rounds of three breaths, that's it, or maybe a little more. We didn't do much also. It was just hardly 5 or 7 minutes, hardly. But just imagine how much is the effect on our body right now. You all are, you know, in so much beautiful energies that you all carry now. So the key is, first thing is continuously practicing it. Second is aligning your breath with your body. And as soon as you continuously do it, gradually, you know, you'll reach a state where automatically the thought process will reduce. Along with that, also slowly emotionally also you'll become balanced. And nobody can shake a person who is emotionally balanced. Why are we challenged so much? Because we are fearful, we are afraid. And if just okay, do this, simply sit upright, make your back straight and see the difference. Is it different? Does it feel different? Because, you know, as soon as you sit straight, you align to the universe and the Mother Earth. And automatically you get that protection that you need. I hope I have answered your question. And along with that, I've given a few more questions in your mind. I can't hear you properly.
I said thanks, I appreciate really.
Oh, my pleasure.
So there is one more question from Harshad. He's saying, along with Navkar, can I say, along with breathing, can I say Navkar mantra in our mind?
Yes, very much. Definitely. Any mantra? Because the Navkar mantra is so dear to us, maybe it comes automatically to us. So definitely, as we are breathing in, deep breathing, along with that, definitely you can do Namaskar mantra. And it can also be so that, you know, one of the methods is to chant Namaskar mantra as soon as you feel fearful. આપણું પહેલું રિએક્શન એ આવે કે આપણે તરત નવકાર મંત્ર બોલવા લાગ્યા, કારણ કે આપણને જેવો ડર લાગવા લાગે કે આપણું પહેલા સૌથી પહેલું એ જ આવે કે ચલો આપણે પહેલા નવકાર મંત્ર બોલીએ. સો ધીસ ઇઝ વેરી નેચરલ. સો લેટ ઇટ બી, વોટ એવર ઇઝ નેચરલ, બી વિથ ઇટ. જેનામાં તમને સિમ્પલ ટૂલ એક આપી દઉં હજી, જ્યાં તમને તકલીફ બહુ પડવા લાગે ને એ આપણા માટે નથી, જે સહજતાથી આવે છે આપણું છે. ઓકે, ગુડ. So now we know, okay, when to do the deep breathing exercise. So whenever you're getting too many thoughts, say for example, ghanivar office work, if you are facing some office ma challenges, office work karu che, and now you want to really, you know, focus on something, at that point again do deep breathing. As soon as you do that, automatically, you know, your body, your energy will be aligned and you'll be able to think clearly. All these practices help us to make our mind sharp, clear thinking, emotionally balanced and healthy physical body. Good. Let's proceed. There were some more questions. Thank you. Yes, you can say Namaskar mantra. Okay. And yeah, recording, I will try to send you. I'm in the process of uploading on the my website. So definitely you can get from there. So you'll get it. So let's proceed now. In fact, I would like all of you to practice it without my voice, so that, you know, I want your feedback on how the, you know, method is for you. How much can you practice? Okay, so next one, second exercise is of Mother Earth meditation. So in the daily routine, first thing, always in the morning, as soon as you get up, sit for some time. There will be no thoughts immediately. That is true meditation. As soon as you feel that there are thoughts coming in, initially you may not realize also that there are thoughts coming in. As soon as you realize, start little deep breathing. And it will be much more easy doing deep breathing in the morning. Simply because our body is also relaxed. Sharir saras shant avastha ma che. So deep breathing, ઊંડા શ્વાસ લેવાનું આર આસાની, વન કેન ડૂ ઇટ ઇઝીલી. આફ્ટર ધીસ યુ કેન ડૂ ધ એક્સરસાઇઝ દેટ વી ડીડ જસ્ટ નાઉ, દેટ ઇઝ મધર અર્થ મેડિટેશન. સિમ્પલી ઇમેજિન, ઇટ કેન બી યોર જસ્ટ વિઝ્યુઅલાઇઝેશન ઓર ઇમેજિનેશન, કે બધી જે પણ તમને નથી જોઈતી ને બધી જ ઉર્જા, ઓલ દેટ એનર્જી ઇઝ ગોઈંગ ટુ ધ મધર અર્થ થ્રુ યોર ફીટ. તમે ખાલી એટલું વિચારશો ને તો પણ એ ઓટોમેટિક થશે. અવર થોટ હેઝ ગ્રેટેસ્ટ પાવર. It can manifest anything and everything. So if you just allow that to happen, automatically the energy will flow, which is not contributing to you. In fact, at energy level, there is no plus, there is no minus. Positive and negative energy na hoi sake, apna emotions apna mate hoi sake. Energy to su che? Neutral che. Pane hamna apne kaam ni nathi, etle apne ne jawa daiye che. So we are allowing that to go. So whichever is not contributing to us. As it goes, of course, something goes, some other thing has to come. So allow and intend, or, you know, you can actually feel that also. There is universal energy flowing into your system. So with every breathing in, take the universal energy and allow that energy to flow to each and every cell of your body. Do this exercise is whenever you are feeling tired after day's work, or maybe in the middle of the day, you can do this exercise and allow all that tiredness to go to Mother Earth. In fact, Mother Earth does not have any point of view about, you know, it is a good energy or bad energy. Good and bad is for us. For Mother Earth, there is no problem. It will take that energy. And if you still have that point of view, you can say that as soon as it reaches Mother Earth, it contributes to Mother Earth. સો આપણને ઘણી વાર એવું લાગે કે આપણે નેગેટિવ એનર્જી મધર અર્થને આપીએ છીએ તો સારું નથી. સો એવું વિચારી કે અને એક્ચ્યુઅલી એવું જ થાય છે, ઇટ ઇઝ કોન્ટ્રીબ્યુટિંગ. સો જેવી એ ધરતી સુધી પહોંચે એટલે ધરતીમાંને સારું આપે છે. સો ઓટોમેટિકલી ઓલ દેટ ઇઝ દેટ ટાયર્ડનેસ, દેટ અનઇઝીનેસ, એવરીથિંગ યુ કેન ગીવ ઇટ ટુ મધર અર્થ એન્ડ અલાઉ ધ એનર્જી ઓફ ધ યુનિવર્સ ટુ ફ્લો ટુ યુ. Once that flow is established, you can be there in five minutes, 10 minutes. Again, you know, be with your own judgment. Tamara sharir ne ketli jarur chhe ane kevi rite kari rahyu chhe, accordingly you can do that. And then again, last part is always, you know, you rub your palms against each other and keep them against on your eyes and slowly, gradually open your eyes. Immediately after, you know, doing such energy work, you may not want to open your eyes because you want to remain in that space. So if it is so, allow yourself to be. Okay, so you can use this exercise as and when you feel not really happy about something or something is not working out for you. All these situations, all these time, you can use this method. Both these methods work wonders. Okay, shall I proceed? Are you all charged up for one more tool? Okay. Yes. Okay, thank you. So let's get to the next one. This is a beautiful, simple meditation. And it really helps because at times we see any of these three methods can work well whenever you want to release some emotion that is not working for you. This is a tool which will help you to release more, to take in the energy of the universe. And along with that, it is a simple technique that you can practice anytime during the day. So let's do it and then we will discuss about it. So again, take your positions. Now I will not say what you all are supposed to do. Do it. I'll see. I actually cannot see everyone, but let's see if I can check. So sit straight. Okay. And now what you're supposed to do is first observe your breath. And this time, we will do the breathing in and breathing out with counting. So we will breathe in for 3 counts and we will breathe out for 5 counts. We will breathe in through the nose and breathe out through the mouth. So breathing in through the nose for 3 counts. So it will go like inhale, 1, 2, 3, and exhale will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But exhalation will take place through the mouth. So inhale through the nose, exhale through the mouth, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Inhale, 2, 3. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Inhale through the nose. Exhale through the mouth. 4, 5. Inhale, 2, 3. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Inhale, 2, 3. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Inhale through the nose. Exhale through the mouth. Inhale through the nose. Exhale through the mouth. 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, One, two, three, four, five. One, two, three. One, two, three, four, five. Inhale through the nose. Exhale through the mouth. Four, five. One, two, three. One, two, three, four, five. One, two, three. One, two, three, four, five. Inhale through the nose. Exhale through the mouth. Four, five. One, two, three. One, two, three, four, five. Keep practicing it. Be aware of your inhalation and exhalation. શ્વાસ લેવાનો અને છોડવાનો બંનેને ધ્યાનમાં રાખીને શરીર અને શ્વાસ બંને ઉપર ધ્યાન કેન્દ્રિત કરવાનું છે. નાકથી શ્વાસ લેવાનો અને મોઢેથી શ્વાસ છોડવાનો. કીપ પ્રેક્ટિસિંગ ઇટ. One, two, three. One, two, three, four, five. One, two, three. One, two, three, four, five. And now, be aware of your breath. Keep observing how the breath is. Also observe how your body is. Now bring your palms together. Rub your palms against each other's and slowly keep your warm palms on your eyes. Gently, when you are ready, open your eyes. Check your body. How is your body now? How is your mental space? Okay. Is it different from what we did so far? Is your mind feeling different? Is your body feeling different? So, how to use this releasing emotion, releasing meditation? Simple technique is observing the breath, focusing on your breath. But this time, so far what we did not do it with the counting. In this case, we will do it with the counting. Inhaling for 3 counts and exhaling for 5 counts. Now, when we exhale more, we allow all the toxins also to go out of our body. So, more exhalation means more releasing of the toxins. So, when it is just even breathing, that is inhalation and exhalation are the same, it takes care of all that, you know, removing all that toxins. But when we exhale more, automatically more and more negative energy, more and more toxins will be released. Secondly, when we are breathing out through the mouth, we are actually allowing everything to go out. So this meditation, even though it looks very simple and there is no technique involved, but this is very powerful meditation. And after doing this meditation, automatically our mental space becomes much more clear. We are almost in a state, if I had continued for some more time, you would be completely in trance. It can be that powerful. So make sure that as you are doing it, this will really, you know, actually help you to become more and more, you know, release all those emotions. Not only emotions, even the mental thoughts, which are not contributing or even which is not required at the moment. All of that will be released. So this, how to use it is simply by observing the breath and practicing 3 counts inhalation, 5 counts exhalation. Now, when to do it? You can do this any time of the day. It can be in the morning, it can be in the, you know, during the day, or it can be at night also. Whenever, you know, you feel that, you know, you want to release some emotion. So there can be sometimes we want to cry, sometimes we want to shout, sometimes if we want to feel, we are angry and we want to express, but we cannot. All these times we can use this emotion, emotion release meditation. So allow that energy to flow out of your system. Don't hold on to these energies, because the diseases and problems occur when we are storing these energies which are not serving us. જે આપણે કામનું નથી એ પકડીને રાખીએ છીએ, એ બધું સંભાળીને રાખીએ છીએ, ત્યારે પ્રોબ્લેમ થાય છે. એઝ સૂન એઝ વી અલાવ ઇટ ટુ ગો આઉટ ઓફ ધ બોડી, આઉટ ઓફ ધ સિસ્ટમ, ઓટોમેટિકલી અવર બોડી બીકમ્સ મોર રિલેક્સ્ડ એન્ડ વી કેન હેવ મોર ક્લેરિટી વેધર ઓર નોટ ઇટ ઇઝ રિક્વાયર્ડ. ઓકે, એની ક્વેશ્ચન સો ફાર? બીકોઝ નાવ વી આર એન્ડ વેન ટુ યુઝ ઓલ્સો આઈ હેવ એક્સપ્લેન. એનીથિંગ એલ્સ દેટ યુ વોન્ટ ટુ આસ્ક અબાઉટ ધીસ મેડિટેશન? Or I'll just, you know, tell you what all, you know, just summarize this. Yes, anyone saying something? Someone saying something?
Why breathing out from the mouth?
Breathing out from the mouth, because when you breathe out from the mouth, automatically all that energy which is not contributing goes out with ease. And with this, you know, we are allowing everything to go out. All the different toxins also. That is why. It will take place with the nose also, but in this particular meditation, we want to release more than take in little, you know, than take in. So for that, you know, it is to be released through the mouth.
Thank you.
Yeah, welcome. So how will you plan your day? Okay, anyone other, you know, anyone has any question? Or else I'll proceed. We have just talked about this, but just to recap and just to summarize, how will you plan your day? So first, always begin with the meditation. So simply sit for some time without talking to anyone, without, you know, going into the details of any technique. The first few moments are very precious. Don't lose out on them. As soon as you get up, simply sit and with the eyes closed, just sit for some time. Next is deep breathing that we did the first one. Allow breathing in and breathing out slightly deeper as compared to what you're breathing at that moment. Next, you can do the Mother Earth meditation. After that, again, you can do some more deep breathing and come out and wrap up your meditation. Now, throughout the day, you can do this emotion release meditation. You can also practice Mother Earth meditation when, you know, if you are feeling discomfort. You can do any of these two meditation. I've written this, you know, throughout the day, because it will be easy for you to continuous, you know, practice it in bits and pieces. If I give you everything to do at one go, it will be like, you know, how much to do. So throughout the day, practice this. Again, just before going to bed, make sure that you do deep breathing. So automatically the systems in our body, the entire physical, emotional, mental system, all of it becomes much more at ease. And then, yeah, this is a question for you now. How else will you implement today's learning? So this is what I thought about it. If anything else comes to your mind, please write it. You can go to Mentimeter and how are you going to practice this? How will you implement it in different way? Please mention all of that. Okay, before bed, all right, very good. Release stress when tired or down. Great. I'll have to shut this. Okay. Practice measured breathing during moments of stress to manage emotions. All of you, please note down, because these inputs are your own and at the same time, they'll be more helpful than this session. Probably combined with some yoga pose, for example, Padmasana. Yes, definitely you can do it with any yoga posture of meditative asana. At night and tired, yes. Start practicing and see how it helps. In the morning, okay. Be aware and practice steps as we have taught today. Okay, more practice. So every time, you know, as and when you get time, maybe you're just sitting for, even if you get 5 minutes, start practicing, observe your breath, do deep breathing. Having break in work hours and use it, definitely you can do that because that will really help your body, help your mind. When you're feeling negative emotions, yes, definitely. In stressful situations as well as free time, teach kids how to implement some of these techniques to manage stress. Yes, definitely you can teach your kids and it will be wonderful contribution towards kids. Okay, when you're feeling negative emotions, yes. Okay, throughout the day, every couple of hours, few minutes, definitely you can do that. Okay, anyone? So we have got so many different techniques, tools for you. We are just about to get, you know, the session is about to get over. If you have any question, let me know. Else I will give my contact details every day few times. Yes. Okay. I think you all also have these answers with you, right? So maybe you can take the screenshots and keep them handy so that as and when you get time, you can remember this and continuously practice this. Okay. Yes, I think we have read almost all of them. So, yes, okay. One more answer after losing UNCFB game. Okay. That's a good one. I never thought of it. Okay, so next is my contact details in case if any one of you have any questions, if you're stuck somewhere in the practice, you can WhatsApp me on this number, you can message me and I will get back to you. And below is my email ID. You can contact me on my email as well. So with this, I complete this session. Thank you so much. Thank you, JSCNC, for giving me this opportunity. And thank you, lovely audience. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Yes.
So Deepika ji, that was wonderfully explained and very informative session. And when you talked about the techniques, right? So I remember one of the techniques in my office, we used to do it. So one of the guys, just like, you know, one of the meditation experts, he came and he, what he did is like in one
thank
room.
You, thank you. Thank you. Harshacha.
So I was talking about one of the techniques what they were doing. So in office they just gather all the employees and they put a loud music and they say, you know, you should dance. Whatever dio tumne aapde wo dance karo tumhe.
Yes, yes.
Aur jo tumhe nahi karo to that guy comes in front of you and he will dance. So make sure that you dance. So he did it for like 3-5 minutes, one or two songs, and then he stopped the music and say, now you try to think something. Because your energy level is so high. We were not able to think anything. And he said, like, you know, this is the state of meditation. That is where you want to reach. So this is like a glimpse of meditation. He just, you know, explained that way. But that time I was very young. I could do that. But now we need to know what technique.
No, that is okay. I forgot to mention and I should have. That is the reason we have Navratri. See, after so much of work, you know, when you want to get, you know, when your body is also tired, but in spite of that, you can dance. And right. the dance is so rejuvenating that it will actually energize your entire body, mind, spirit, everything. તમારું આખું શરીર બધું જેટલો થાક હશે બધું ઉતરી જશે.
Very nice, very nice. So yeah, thank you so much again. Yes. And comments in the chat window, responses, the way people question, says it all. I don't need to mention, you know, how members like this session. And I just want to, you know, say one more round of applause for you. So let's have...
Thank you so much. It's
and
an honor.
Any your contact information. So anybody have any follow-up questions or, you know, you want to talk to her for some more things, please contact her. She already mentioned that. And before the session also, she agreed that, like, you know, feel free if any members want to, you know, reach out to her if needed. I guess anyone was, you know, speaking in between. Anybody has any question or? All right, I think we are good. Okay, so moving to the next section for today's meeting is announcements. The eSouvenir project. So eSouvenir committee has finished reviewing major JSENC activities articles. And now we are moving to the finalizing the eSouvenir. So, I mean, it is really, really, you know, a lot of content. I would say, like, you know, more than 100 pages we are looking at right now. And I don't know, you know, how that will turn around. But yes, we are trying our best to finalize as soon as possible. Next announcement is from Jaina Initiative. Jaina has undertaken the initiative to collect the funds for Sadharmik Bhakti to help Jain families in India. Jaina is reaching out to families who are experiencing unfortunate this financial conditions by COVID. So please visit jaina.org for more information and how to donate towards this. Now the next announcement is about November discourse, and this is something, you know, I was really excited to announce this to all the members. As I mentioned in the last meeting, committee is planning something very interesting and maybe one of a kind for JSENC. So think about this. Wouldn't it be wonderful to take entire JSENC family to do Paritana Jatra together as a son? It would surely be wonderful, but maybe not practical. So what we thought is, how about doing this virtual Bhav Yatra of Shetrunjay this year? And I cannot think of better days than Diwali days. Taking advantage of technology, this is something we can do best in this difficult time. So who is going to do this Bhav Yatra? For that, we have invited young Jain Vidhikar, Srenik Bhai Gala, and team of musicians. So Srenik Bhai will explain to us why Palitana is so, so special. Detailed information right from the Taleti to the Darbar of Dada. In short, he will tell us anything and everything about Palitana. I'm sure after that Bhav Yatra, our understanding of Palitana will change forever. And we'll even get to know more about this Yatra when we visit next time. So this event will be live and again heavily relied on technology. Committee is closely working with Srenik Bhai and trying to manage all the logistics needed. Also, I'm in talk with a few other Jain centers and see if they can join us in this wonderful journey. So members, I have humble requests. So please don't miss next meeting and let's celebrate Diwali with Shetrunjay Bhav Yatra. And also, you know, please ask your friends, families, anywhere in the world to be part of this wonderful journey. We would be happy to have them. This will be YouTube live event, so any number of people can join. So look forward for announcement, email, more about this particular Bhav Yatra. So that's all with respect to announcements. Now it's time for Uvasagram, and today we have Marmi Cheda, who is going to lead that for us. Over to you, Marmi.
Thank you. Uvasagram basam, basam vandami gamagira muktam, visa visa ninnasam, mangal kalyana avasam, विषयफूलिङ्गमन्तं कंतिदाय चोषय मनः तस्य गोगमय दत्त जयति वसनं चित्ताउ दोरे मन्तो तुच्छ पुनमु विभव फल हुए नवते सुविजीवा पवतीन दुख दो गचम तू असमते लते चिंता मणि कप पाय वपहिये पावंती अभिगेनम जीवाय मनंतान ये संतु माय सो पुत्ति पुण्य पुण्य ही न तादेव दिज्ज बोहिं बबे बबे पासा जन चंदा Thank you.
Thank you, Marmi. And with that, we reached the end of the monthly meeting. Thanks for joining. Please be safe. Bolo bolo sankhe swasthya bhagwan ki jai.